What do YouTube? B. Kelly back again with another banger. Today's video, I'm making my SEC football predictions for the 2020 college football season. First, I will be going over the SEC West. My first place spot for the SEC West goes to Alabama. I think they will finish 12-0 on the season, and the first game is supposed to be USC. But I don't know if USC is actually going to play them. I've seen rumors about TCU. But any team that plays a Pac-12 team, if they play Alabama, Alabama's winning no matter what. You can't change my mind at all. And then they'll play Georgia State the next week, and I think they're going to obliterate them. I'm sorry, Georgia State, you're not going to get another SEC non-conference win like you did with Tennessee this past season. Georgia. Now, this game's going to be College Game Day, and you cannot change my mind at all. This is going to be a very good game, and I'm very interested in it, but I'm giving it to Alabama. Then they play Kent State, and this one's going to be Alabama, probably by like 28+. And then Lane Kiffin and Ole Miss play Alabama at home. Well, too bad for Ole Miss. I have them losing this game to Alabama. And then Alabama plays at Arkansas. I have Alabama winning that one. Then they go against Mike Leach and the air raid system of Mississippi State. And I have Alabama winning that one as well. And then Alabama travels to Tennessee, and I have them winning that game as well. And then Alabama goes to Death Valley, LSU, the national champions, Coach O's place. And you know what? I got Alabama coming back from last season. I have them winning this game. Then they have a cupcake game with UT Martin, have them winning that one. And then they get to play Kellen Mond and Texas A&M, have them winning that one by 17. And then they finish their season off in the Iron Bowl, home against Auburn. And I know this season is going to be a redemption season, so I have them winning this game and going 12-0 in the regular season. With my second place spot in the SEC West, I have the Auburn Tigers and Bo Nix. And I mean, they open up with a very easy game versus Alcorn State. And even though they're finished 9-3 is my prediction, I have them taking the second place spot just because of how they'll do in SEC play. I have them beating Alcorn State, but their second game of the season, North Carolina, I actually have them losing to them. I think North Carolina is a very big sleeper team this season, but they'll pick it up yet again, beating Ole Miss, Southern Miss, and Kentucky, but I have them losing to Georgia. And then they'll pick it back up yet again, beating Texas A&M, Mississippi State, Arkansas, UMass, and beating LSU before the Iron Bowl. But like I said earlier, Alabama's on a revenge tour, and I think they're going to beat Auburn in the Iron Bowl on the season finale. With my third place spot in the SEC West, I have the LSU Tigers. Now, the LSU Tigers, even though they just came off a national championship, they lost the most starters in the NCAA. They literally lost almost everybody and anybody. But they still have Ja'Marr Chase. Now, even though I do have them as third place, they still have a really good season. They are 10-2. And I have them going on a roll in the beginning of the season, beating UTSA, Texas, Rice, Ole Miss, Nicholls, Florida, Arkansas, and Mississippi State. But then they play Alabama at home, and I have them losing. But then they'll beat South Carolina and lose to Auburn. And in the season finale at College Station, I have them beating Texas A&M. But they're going to be third place because of the two losses in the SEC West play by Alabama and Auburn. With my fourth spot in the SEC West, I have Texas A&M, home of the 12th man. Now, last year they had arguably one of the hardest schedules in all of college football, and it really reflected in their record, but they beasted in the bowl game, especially in the second half against OSU. But the question is, they have the coaching, they have the players, but will they be able to put it all together this season? I do have them starting off very strong, but then hitting a bad losing skid and finishing 7-5. Now, I do have them starting off strong, beating Abilene Christian, North Texas, Colorado, Arkansas, Mississippi State, Fresno State, but then I have them losing to Auburn, South Carolina, Ole Miss. And then I have them beating Vanderbilt, but back to the losing skid with Alabama and LSU back-to-back games. But they'll go back to the bowl game, which is good, I guess. With the fifth place spot in the SEC West, I have Mississippi State. And even though they did bring in, I think, one of the best coaches in college football, Mike Leach, and an offensive-minded genius, I think they will go 7-5 this season. I think they will beat New Mexico, NC State, Arkansas, Tulane, but then they end up on a losing skid to Texas A&M, Alabama, LSU, Auburn. But they'll win another game against Mizzou, and then they'll lose to Terry Wilson in Kentucky, beat Alabama A&M, and beat Ole Miss in the Egg Bowl, which I think is going to be a very good game. Lane Kiffin versus Mike Leach. It's definitely going to be a historic one, to say the least. My sixth spot in the SEC West, I have Ole Miss under Lane Kiffin. Now, I do have them finishing 6-6, but I have them losing their home opener versus Baylor, and I have them beating Southeast Missouri, but then they go on a losing skid, losing to Auburn, LSU, and Alabama. But they have a gimme win against Vanderbilt. But then they lose to Florida, beat UConn, another gimme win. And then I have them actually winning against Texas A&M, Arkansas, and Georgia Southern. And then we have the Egg Bowl. Mike Leach and Lane Kiffin. Well, let's just say, I said it earlier, I think Mike Leach is winning this one, and I have Ole Miss finishing 6-6. With the last place finish spot, 7th place, I have Arkansas in the SEC West. Now, I think they'll improve from 2-10 last year to 5-7, especially with Felipe Franks and Rakeem Boyd, who I think is one of the most underrated running backs in all of college football right now. Start watching him play football, guys. He's really good. Even though Arkansas sucks, he's one of the best running backs out there. I do have them beating Nevada, but I have them getting creamed by Notre Dame, losing to Mississippi State, losing to A&M, beating Charleston Southern, losing to Alabama and LSU, but I have an upset on Halloween. I have them beating Tennessee, but then they lose to Auburn and Ole Miss. But they beat UL Monroe, and they win the rivalry game in Kansas City, Missouri, Arrowhead Stadium. I have them beating Mizzou. Now time for the SEC East. My first place spot for the SEC East is Georgia. I have them beating Virginia, ETSU, but week 3 losing at Alabama, and then winning the rest of their games beating ULM, Vanderbilt, Auburn, Missouri, Florida, South Carolina, Tennessee, Kentucky, and Georgia Tech. For my second place spot in the SEC East, I have Florida, and I have them finishing 10-2 on the season. I have them beating Eastern Washington, Kentucky, South Alabama, Tennessee, South Carolina, but then I have them losing at Death Valley, LSU. And then I have them beating Ole Miss, but losing to Georgia, which will ultimately make them second place in the SEC East. And then I have them winning out, being Vanderbilt, Missouri, New Mexico State, and Florida State. Now, I might get some hate for this one, but my third place spot in the SEC East is Kentucky. Now, here's why. Last year, Kentucky could have won a lot of games in the SEC, but they really didn't have a quarterback. I mean, Lynn Bowden Jr. is not a quarterback. He is a wide receiver / running back. He is extremely quick, but he could not throw the ball very well at all. The defense was good, and I expected the defense to be good again. And Terry Wilson, hopefully he's healthy the full season, because that's what I'm basing it off of. I think they'll go 9-3 and be third place in the SEC East, because Terry Wilson is a very underrated starting quarterback. I have them beating Eastern Michigan, but losing to Florida, beating Kent State, beating South Carolina, but losing to Auburn, beating Eastern Illinois, beating Vanderbilt, beating Mizzou, beating Tennessee, beating Mississippi State, but losing to Georgia, and beating their rivals, Louisville. Now my fourth place spot in the SEC East is a team that went 4-8 last season, South Carolina. I think they're going to improve a lot, especially with Ryan Helinski. I think they're going to win their first game against Coastal Carolina, beat East Carolina, beat Mizzou, but then lose to Kentucky, Florida, but then get back to winning against Tennessee and Texas A&M and Vanderbilt. But They have a tough final four stretch games. I think they're going to lose to Georgia, LSU, and Clemson, but beat Wofford. With my fifth place spot in the SEC East, I have Tennessee. Now, they started off very slow last season and finished very strong. But I have them going 5-7 this season, depending on how healthy other teams are. I just feel like they're not going to live up to the hype yet again. I feel like they will beat Charlotte in the home opener, but then lose to OU. And then I have them beating Furman, but losing to Florida, beating Mizzou, but losing to South Carolina, and then losing to Alabama, Arkansas, Kentucky, Georgia, but then winning their final two games against Troy and Vanderbilt to be 5-7. Now for my sixth place spot in the SEC East, I have Mizzou. Even though they went 6-6 last year, I really don't see them going up. They got a new head coach, but I don't see it improving from last season. Because last season, I mean, you know, had some up and downs in the beginning. You know, they got a good start after the Wyoming game, but they fell apart with injuries such as Kelly Bryant. But nonetheless, I have them beating Central Arkansas and Vanderbilt, but then losing to South Carolina, but then beating Eastern Michigan, but then, oh my, losing to Tennessee, BYU, Georgia, Kentucky, Mississippi State, and Florida, but beating Louisiana in one of their last two games, and going into their rivalry game with Arkansas, I have them losing. Now for my last place spot in the SEC East, and the worst team in my mind in the SEC is Vanderbilt. I have them going 1-11. I do have them beating Mercer in the home opener, but I have them losing to Mizzou, K-State, Colorado State, Georgia, Ole Miss, Kentucky, South Carolina, Florida, Texas A&M, Louisiana Tech, and Tennessee. And if you guys like this video, I'm doing this video with all the conferences, FBS, Division I. And you know, if you guys like this video, share it, smash that like button, subscribe, and turn on the post notifications, because this is what I'm going to be putting out during these next few weeks.